I am come in my Father's name, and ye receive me not. If another shall come in his own name, him ye will receive. John 5:43. God's name is Yahuwah, or Yahweh, or Elohim. Jesus' name is Yahusha, Yeshua, or Yahawashai. The Holy Spirit's name is Ruhakadesh. These are their original Hebrew names. Dad, thank you. In Yahusha's name. Exodus 20:9-10. Work and get everything done during 6 days a week. But the seventh day is a day of rest to honor the Lord. 1 John 5:4. This is the victory that conquers the world, our faith. We need one day in which work comes to a screeching halt. We need one 24-hour period in which the wheels stop grinding and the motor stops turning. We need to stop. There's a verse that summarizes many lives. Man is a mere phantom as he goes to and fro. He hustles about, but only in vain. He heaps up wealth, not knowing who will get it. Psalm 39:6. Does that sound like you? Does that sound like your life? Are you so seldom in one place that your friends regard you as a phantom? Are you so constantly on the move that your family is beginning to question your existence? Do you take pride in your frenzy at the expense of your faith? Listen, slow down. If God commanded it, you need it. I have an idea. Take a day to say no to work and yes to worship. No to work, yes to worship. What is unique about the kingdom of God is that you are assured victory. You have won. You are assured that someday you will stand before the face of God and see the King of Kings. You are assured that someday you will enter a world where there will be no more pain, no more tears, no more sorrow. Listen, if you have no faith in the future, then you have no power in the present. If you have no faith in the life beyond this life, then your present life is going to be powerless. But if you believe in the future and are assured of victory, then there should be a dance in your step, a pep in your step, and a smile on your face. Hey, now, I just can't help myself. I can't help myself. So I ask you, are you winning or just grinning? Please listen. Vision is the precedent for passion. Passion means that no matter how tough things are, what you believe is bigger than what you see. Passion keeps you focused on your vision. There's no way any of us can move toward our dreams without a plan. Now, a vision becomes a plan when it is captured, fleshed out, and written down. If you don't have a plan in your life, you have nothing to refer to when you want to make sure you're on track. When ideas are cultivated, they become imagination. Imagination. Imagination, if it is watered and developed, becomes a plan. Listen, finally, if a plan is followed, it becomes a reality. Victory, see. So I ask you again, are you winning or just grinning? You be blessed now, you hear?